isa na namang budget stunner ang dumating dito sa ating table. And today, pag-uusapan natin, it's the Redmi 12C ni Xiaomi. So this one is the successor of the highly successful na Redmi 10C. And papakita ko sa inyo guys na kung ano ang meron dito sa phone na ito, gaano siya kamura, and gaano siya ka-performer para sa inyo. Tara, simulan natin with the unboxing. So hi guys, Opera Solution with the Gadget Psychic and welcome back to my channel. So this is the Redmi 12C. Itong phone na ito comes with a very budget-friendly price. 3GB of RAM, 32GB of storage is priced at $5,499. And kanyang 4GB of RAM, 64GB of storage would sell at $6,499. And ang kanyang 4GB of RAM, 128GB of storage would sell at $7,499. There's another one, online exclusive, 6GB of RAM, 128GB of storage would sell at $8,999. But before anything else, buksan muna natin itong box na ito. So right now guys, i-unbox natin ang budget device na nilabas si Xiaomi, which is the Redmi 12C. So previously, na-review natin yung Redmi 10C, and I can say that one was definitely very solid pagdating sa value for money. And let's see kung itong Redmi 12C would still be the same. So what I have here is the lavender purple version and 4GB of RAM, 128GB of storage. Buksan muna natin. Okay, so this is the unit itself. So kita natin na nakabalit ng plastic. So kailangan muna natin bilasin yung plastic. So indeed, itong lavender purple is quite refreshing. Kita natin may mga stripes siya dito sa unit itself. And of course, ito ang hindi nagbago ang kanyang fingerprint scanner na dito pa rin sa likod, which is quite outdated by the way. And andyan ang kanyang camera module sa likod. Sa ilalim, still micro USB port together with ang kanyang microphone interface ng kanyang loudspeaker. Then dito ang kanyang power button, of course, ang kanyang volume rocker. Sa ibabaw ang kanyang audio jack. And on the other side, ang kanyang SIM tray. Sundutin lang natin. So kita natin, we have a triple card slot dito. So dalawang 4G SIM plus isang micro SD expansion. So some quick spec, Helio G85, 6.71-inch screen, 50MP na camera, and of course, 5,000mAh na battery. Check lang natin other things inside the box. Andito ang kanyang SIM ejector tool. And pag binuksan natin, there's a lot of documentation, which is andito. Quick start guide, safety information guide, and of course, warranty card. Micro USB cable. And ang kanyang 10 watts na charging brick. And ang kanyang... So yun guys, nakita na natin ang unboxing nito phone na ito. And this is the Redmi 12C. So kanyang design has improved over the Redmi 10C. And I can say na ang kanyang camera bump looks a little bit better than the 10C. Plus yung kanyang design has improved. And yeah, I love the color purple here. Only one thing na talagang minana niya from 10C is ang kanyang micro USB na charging port. Now, itong phone na ito is being powered by the MediaTek Helio G85. It's a 12-nanometer chip. It's a little bit of step down from the Snapdragon 680, which is 6-nanometer chip. Now, continuing na naman natin sa kanyang benchmark score dito sa AnTuTu Benchmark, 215,000 points. Hindi naman siya nagkakalayo doon sa benchmark na kuha natin for Redmi 10C. Now, if you break it down, here are the scores na makikita natin. So, checking some score dito sa Wildlife, sa 3D Mark. Checking some results dito sa Geekbench. Of course, itong phone na ito, chinarge natin from 10 to 100. It took me near 3 hours just to complete the full charging cycle. Now, tinayin naman natin siya, i-check ang kanyang benchmark sa battery stress test. And this was the result, 13 hours and 5 minutes. And this one is set at 50% brightness on the 60Hz of screen refresh rate. So on daily average usage, I can say na itong phone na ito, kaya naman na magtagal for near 2 days on normal usage. It means na you're using for Facebook, for social media, for Viber, video chat, messenger chat, and of course, some video calls is okay. Basta as long as almost always nakakonek sa Wi-Fi, well, sometimes naka-mobile data and watching videos and playing some mild games. Yeah, kaya naman na magtagal ng 2 days. Now, swiping left and right, even though that this is a very budget-friendly device, I don't see any lags along the way. Now, ang kanyang screen is almost the same sa Redmi 10C. It both has the 6.71-inch na IPS LCD. And ang kanyang maximum brightness dito sa phone na ito is 500 nits. And ang kanyang screen-to-body ratio is around mga 83%. So, kita natin na medyo makapal ang mga chin niya, mga side bezels niya, and this one still has the teardrop notch. Kanya-kanya ng front glass is being protected by the Corning Gorilla Glass. I'm not quite sure, Corning Gorilla, probably Corning Gorilla Glass 3. Ang kanyang side is plastic frames. And ang kanyang likod is, of course, definitely plastic back. Now, watching videos dito sa YouTube and sa Netflix, it's okay. I can say, napang-entertain naman siya. And what I can say is that, okay, malaki naman kanyang screen. You can watch all of your favorite Korean novela dito. It's pretty much watchable. And probably one problem na napansin ko dito is when you're under the bright sunlight, medyo mahirapan ka ng konti kasi 500 nits na ka na maximum brightness. Now, single firing loudspeaker lang meron na dito, and definitely hindi naman siya ganun kalakasan when you're listening to Spotify or when you're watching videos or when you're playing games. I would suggest na you could use your favorite headphone jack dito or you can use your favorite Bluetooth TWS. Now, speaking of gaming, naglaro naman tayo Call of Duty Mobile dito sa phone na ito. Well, as far as I'm concerned, so dinemo natin laruin ng Call of Duty Mobile dito. So binabaan natin ang graphical settings nito to low settings. So I was able to breeze through okay naman ang game na ito. Even though na hindi ganun kaganda ang graphics, but at the very least, masasabi ko, wala namang napansin na lag along the way, which is okay. Ang screen is responsive sa akin touch, and the sound is just okay. Would probably be using a Bluetooth headphones or a wired headset for more immersive experience. And itong Redmi 12C is running on Xiaomi MIUI 13 and inside the Android 12 system. So I hope na magkaroon dito ng upgrade into MIUI 14 pretty soon. Nang pag-usapan natin ang ganyang camera dito, and this one has a 50MP na main camera sensor with a 0.08MP na depth sensor. This one can record up to 1080p and 30fps. And sa harap natin, ang kanyang teardrop notch is a 5MP na front-facing shooter with a 1080p 30fps na video recording capability. Now, taking this phone outdoors, I can say I was able to take in some pretty decent shots. And what I can say is, quite na-impressed naman ako sa kanya dahil some of these shots can match even that of a mid-ranger. Pero one thing na napansin ko dito sa kanyang camera, sometimes hit and miss siya. May times na okay, maganda ka ng mga shots, but there are times na hindi rin ganun ka-okay ang kanyang mga shots, medyo blurred. Now, probably one of its problem dito sa phone nito is a little bit slower siya mag-focus, like this one. I was supposed to focus dito sa mga flowers, so, but instead, nag-focus siya dito sa gitna ng stem. But overall, some of these building shots like this are pretty much decent. And taking indoors, okay rin mga shots na nakuha ko, like mga food shots and some of these coffee mug shots, pretty much okay. Some of these product shots are quite good. And some of these building shots are quite good. Except that yung kanyang building dito sa likod is halos namuti na lang siya. Now, taking on some selfies outdoors, quite nice. Very sharp naman ng mga photos na nakuha ko. No? It was a quite surprise for a 5MP na camera. But there are times na like this one, medyo dark. So, medyo mapapansin mo, magda-darken din ang mukha mo. Some indoor shots na well-lit is quite good ang iyong mga selfie shot. So, taking in some videos using the front-facing camera, here are some samples.
So guys, this is the Redmi 12C and recording using the front-facing camera. I can say that this one can help you get some pretty decent vlogging experience. And yeah, you can also use this for Zoom meetings and for Viber video chat. And probably one of the problems that I can see is that, well, if you're against the sunlight, well, you'll see something like this. But if you're properly lit, yeah, it's pretty decent.
Now guys, ano masasabi ko dito sa Redmi 12C? Starting at a very budget price point at the 5,499 price range, this phone is pretty much capable. And what I can say that okay siya dahil expandable yung kanyang memory. You can opt for 32 gigs of storage and buy a well expandable memory card should you need it. And another thing na gusto ko rin sa kanya is tumatagal lang kanyang battery for up to 2 days. Kanyang design is quite trendy except that nandito pa rin kanyang fingerprint scanner which is very quite outdated. Ang kanyang screen is quite okay and ang kanyang camera is quite decent as well. Now, kanino ko marerecommend tong phone na ito? I would say that this one is pretty much geared towards sa mga young professionals, sa mga students na medyo tight ang budget. Itong phone na ito can definitely perform, but of course, don't expect that this one can play all those heavy games na nilalaro ninyo. This one can play those very basic games like Call of Duty Mobile at a lower settings and Mobile Legend. But if you're trying to run Genshin Impact dito, I would say just forget about it. This phone is perfect for social media, viewing your documents, sending some emails, pretty much okay siya. If you'd like to know kung saan nyo pwede mabili itong phone na ito, I'll be linking everything on the description box below. Just check it out. And if you like this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and of course, click nyo na yung bell icon para hindi nyo mamiss mga future uploads dito sa aking channel. And so, ako pala si Richmond, and you're watching Gadget Sidekick. Watch out!